If you're watching this video on a laptop, in between watching more cat videos, you may have noticed the sound of the fans whirring away, trying to keep your slim technological miracle of form and function cool. Heat is a natural enemy of electronics. It can cause computers to slow and crash and damage important hardware to boot. So scientists at Duke University have been exploring a new technique inspired by insect wings to keep your CPU as cool as you are. The concept behind every cooling system ever is basically the same. Take heat from a hot area and move it to somewhere less hot. Repeat ad infinitum. The details of how different systems do this can vary a lot, and they range from simple to ingenious. Heat sinks let the electronics warm a set of metal fins with a large surface area, while a fan blows cool air over the fins. The air warms up, absorbing the heat, and then is blown away. Only the most powerful pre-90s computers needed these, but now they're a staple of home computers and have made higher processing speeds possible. Heat pipes contain liquid and use heat to turn it into a vapor, which then travels to a cooler part of the pipe to condense again. The liquid then naturally flows back to the hot areas along grooves on the inside of the pipe because the liquid is attracted to a material, a phenomenon known as capillary action. No pumps or gravity are required, so this is a technique that many satellites use to manage heat while in space. Like a heat pipe, the new system developed at Duke also uses vaporizing liquid as a means to carry heat away. A sponge-like material is filled with liquid, and it rests just under the surface that needs to be cooled. The liquid absorbs the heat until it turns into a vapor and leaves the sponge, taking the heat along with it. Below the sponge is a cool surface for the liquid to condense on, but it's been specifically designed to be super hydrophobic. I'm not talking about regular hydrophobic like oil and water. I mean super hydrophobic like a cat. It actively repels it. It does this by mimicking the microscopic bumps on the wings of a cicada. Condensing water droplets sit on these little bumps like a person sits on a bed of nails. When droplets merge, though, they leap into the air. This is because when the two droplets come together, their overall surface area is reduced. The energy that was once used to keep the droplets flat on the hydrophobic surface is suddenly released, popping the drop straight up. Cicadas use this phenomenon to keep their wings clean, while the cooler uses it to return liquid to the sponge to move more heat away. There are a few benefits of a cooling system like this. It works in any orientation, is independent of gravity, and can also passively cool moving hotspots that naturally occur. If an area of the electronic device gets hotter than the rest, it'll just evaporate more liquid from the sponge. Other techniques either can't target hotspots at all, making them ill-suited to cool large areas, or they have to use power to target moving hotspots, making this system less efficient. The technology has a ways to go before it's ready, as the scientists have to find materials that will last long term, but they're optimistic about their progress so far. After working on this for a few years, the researchers claim that their technique is on par with the performance of the most common technology used now, copper heat spreaders. But it has the potential to surpass it. While new technologies that promise to make high-performance electronics and electric cars better is exciting, my favorite part of this whole story is that the researchers who developed this new technology are the same ones who first observed how cicada wings repelled water way back in 2013. They suggested it might be used as a way to cool devices, and here we are 4 years later, and they're doing exactly what they imagined we would. Don't you love the progress of science? You're probably watching this video on a phone or computer right now, hopefully it didn't get too hot, but staring at screens all day, is that bad for your eyes? Check out this episode to find out. You got a science question that you'd like us to answer? Let us know down in the comments. Please subscribe so you get more videos, and thanks for watching.